What's up guys, it's Devani here and welcome back to another Pokemon Duel video. Today we have a new deck to discuss. There we go, I can barely talk. As you guys all know, sandwich decks. You know, with the Deoxys defense form and then with Sableye. And some even people try to run Toxapex with Affini and a couple Silent Toads. But here's the deal. Here is why this deck is better than all the other sandwich decks. At first, Nebby also has a lot of purple. And the thing is, Teleport would normally be bad because you cannot get back to her goal. But guess what? Nebby can go straight back because Teleport is two spaces away. And because Nebby cannot be surrounded, he can just easily go back to that spot and chill over there. So even if one of your Cosmogs die, and one of your Corbelian, and then your Corbelian dies, it's still not over yet. You can still defend with only your Cosmog since it cannot be surrounded. And that's already pretty strong. And then you have the Excadrills, which not only beat Zorak without the Steel Energy in the Metal Sphere, but they can also take the goal with Drill Run, or just dig their way to victory, and they can also act like Empoleons. And then I have the Heatran, and then you think, like, why not triple Excadrill? There are actually three reasons for that. At first, I do not have a third Excadrill, but if I would have had, there are two reasons why I would not have done it. At first, if I use three of a certain mon, it's going to be weak to Phantom Energy because they can essentially banish one of them. And banish decks are a counter to this deck. And also Popplio is a counter to this deck because Popplio doesn't act like a gold. Popplio doesn't have any gold attacks, but it acts like a gold attack because it removes all the purple. So that can be really, really threatening against a Nebby. But back to what I was saying, why Heatran? Heatran can actually burn figures as well. And it doesn't really matter, you can just deploy whenever you want. If you have two of the PC, you will still have one on the bench, and that just keeps cycling again and again and again. And best of all, the Excadrills also benefit from steel energy and metal sphere. And why, Devani, do you have the counterattack if you will be defending most of the time? Well, Nebby can get 3 MP with counterattack, and essentially getting 5 MP with the teleport, which can actually win matches. I have not had that happen to me before, but it probably will happen once. And the reason why I leveled up completely not to level 4, I didn't have enough resources, and Corbelian will not get attacked that much, so it's not really a big deal. I'll level him up later if the deck is actually really successful. So I'll try to find a match and I'll see you guys when I am at the match, so you guys don't go away, we're right here. Alright guys, we found a match, let's see who our dual opponent is. It's gonna be Daniel running a rush deck. This can hurt me now. This can really, really hurt me. Rush decks, man. The rush decks. Let's see if we can beat rush decks with a slow deck that needs setup. I doubt it, but we'll see. We have long throw, we have basically anything else that also helps against the rush. Unfortunately, we have to go first. So we have to use the long throw right now. I'm not letting this guy give me a taste of my own medicine. I'm not letting this guy do that. I'm not gonna let him do that. I'm not. I'm just not. Actually, I might not even pop the place at all. Just because of Zorak. I might not even pop him. Okay. I can't get Nebby out at this point because it's risky with the gold attacks. I'll try it later on. Does he have the scoop up? He doesn't. Okay. So we're gonna go for the surround kill on the speed Deoxys. Wait a second. Ah, he has Gold Block. Okay. Damn it. We're gonna go for the knockout. He has Zoroark, but we have a 101. So we might be okay. Dig. I like it. I actually like that. Yeah, we'll do this. Let's get rid of the other illusion. Well, get that cross counter for me. Ooh, lucky dodge. That was a lucky dodge. Gotta actually have to be honest there. Okay. Goku's is my double surround. Okay, I'm actually gonna place the guy next to my pavilion. Because I don't like double surrounds. Who does? I do get it. And it's gonna work out for him, okay. That's fine. Magic here, and we do. But now he's burned. Coco, so that's at least very nice. And he still does not have, he also has not, don't have Scuba, which he cannot use to get Zoroark's illusion back. That's the reason why I actually use Scuba in the worst decks. That's one of the main reasons. Also to back up speed for me and my goal. Okay, that's gonna be the knockout. Oh, we got an unexpected power. So we should be back now. And just like that, it beat Zoroark. It beat Zoroark. And now we just have to wait until the entry point. I mean, until Exodrill gets knocked out so we can put our Nevi back. So we'll just wait until it gets knocked out. In the meantime, I'll max revive this other Exodrill. Cyclone Kick. Dig on Weak Spot will be really good. Dodge is even better. Okay, I'll take that. I'll take that. That's really, really nice. Unfortunately, we have to take that spot there. I don't want to pop any spear. I don't want to pop the plates too, man. This is bad. But we have the counterattack, so let's see if we can cheese him out. We have the counterattack, so we should be okay. Does he know we have counterattack? Let's find out. He takes the entry point now. Let's see if he knows that we have counterattack. Once we go off with the entry point with Excadrill, we could be able to do stuff. Oh. Drill can be game. I mean, Dig can be game, that's what I meant. And that's gonna be the game. That is gonna be a game. And just like that. Boom, there we go. So, you don't have to use the sphere and the energy plate all the time. When you know they have a lot of Zorks, like in this deck, don't use your sphere and your energy. Because that will keep you out 1-on-1, which is a perfect counter to Zork. In the other case, yes, do it. And the reason why I'm saving all these boosts is because I expect a team event coming soon. I really expect a team event. Let's open this though. Drowsy, okay. Grandmother EX, nice. So we can level up some figures with the next upcoming banner. I need that. I really needed that. So we're gonna play one more match. If that next match is pretty short, we'll play another, but I'm gonna try to find a match and I'll see you guys later. So we found another opponent, and Tarvold! Oh my goodness gracious, we're facing Tarvold. We are facing Tarvold. Let's see what we can do. This is exciting, this is quality content right here. This is quality content. So we have to go first, so we're gonna use Long Throw. I don't even know what this deck is about. This is probably about giving weight, but Ampharos has beaten like which removes weight. I don't know. I don't know if that is any good. Removing weight in a weight deck is kind of strange. I'll ask him after this game why he did that. Why he carries Ampharos just for the mega, but the beacon light is not going to be very nice. I'll ask him after this game. I really want to know that. And this guy also gives a lot of weight with the lively dance. So that's pretty interesting. So we're just gonna try to set up here. I don't think Wade deck is really gonna be effective against my deck here. We will just see. He also does not have any good gold attackers. Zoo energy, and then the Mighty Sphere. No, sorry. Metal Sphere. What are his plates? Let me check it. He has a double Ampharosite and a Long Throw plate. Long Throw will probably be useful for this little man, this Ludicolo. So we'll pump the Metal Sphere as well. 100% miss. We're gonna Yeah, okay. We're gonna move him right there. Voila. I don't know what his danger signal do. Size of the Pavadot or Timebo can move within their MP range. We'll put this guy on my entry point, that's not a big deal. And we'll just try to claim that spot right there. That's all we're gonna try to do, and we do. Earthquake, please, do not screw me up here. Do not screw me up. And he screws himself up, which is pretty nice. We get poisoned, but that's not a really big deal. Wait, oh, we cannot be poisoned. Nice, we cannot be poisoned. This deck completely counters his deck. Because we're just gonna stall out, so weight doesn't really matter. We're not gonna defend that much. And we can't get poisoned. So these Siphon Toads are basically useless. He's gonna bring back his time point and his Seismitoad with Mega Ampharos. I'm sure. We all know that's gonna happen. And the good deal is, Lively Dance will make everyone that spins white wait, gain weight. But the Cosmox do not have that much weight. They don't actually have a lot of white at all. So we should be fine. Ampharosite, I'm guessing. Vibration, what does that do? I think it gives my Heatran and my extra heal. Yeah, way too. Yep, okay. Not a really big deal, but still pretty scary. I'm gonna go for Dig against the Pulpitoad to surround Seismitoad most likely. Yeah, we have to make this move, but it's not gonna be that big of a deal because he cannot reach the Nebbies this turn, so we should be okay. So we can always move the Nebbies if we want to, because those will probably never get weighed. Okay. Okay, Tarfold is now really, really salty. I can tell. And I'm also salty. The two misses in a row, that is pretty funny. Earthquake is not gonna do anything else but knock out my Excadrill, which is fine. Yeah, he's probably gonna bring back his Seismitoad. And he's gonna attack my my Cosmo. Because it's not steel type, so it can get poisoned. It will get poisoned. Ooh, it's gonna get a splash here. But good deal is we do have the max revive. So we're obviously gonna use that. Get next to my Kobalion again. I'll get poisoned, but a poison Nebby doesn't really matter. I mean, Splash is not gonna knock anything out, but that will almost never happen. probably a bad move on my end. Should not have done that. Because now I can never get that entry point back. Unless he attacks me now and I knock him out. Ooh, lucky. You got a little lucky there, not gonna lie. I will attack this guy. If he sets Siphon Toad next to Heatran, he got them all. Knock out this Mega Ampharos. Probably not. Okay, he's gonna go for it. Maybe a lucky miss? Probably not. Okay, that's fine. Because I do think, yeah, Seismito will get paralyzed now. And I can still deploy my Excadrill next turn. Because I need to knock out one of his toads. Otherwise, things are gonna get really, really bad. Oh, this can hurt now. This can honestly hurt. I have all the plays used. Wait, why does my Cobalion have the Mud Energy? Why does it have the Mud Energy? I don't know why. I have no idea. I don't know why that happened. So he's obviously gonna try to knock me out here. I mean, to get the Bumpy Vibration, which he doesn't. I'm actually not gonna put Nebby there again. I'm not gonna do it. I'm gonna need to knock out one of his figures here. Dig? I mean, not really, right? Not really. Doesn't really work. I mean, my Cobalion can now move. He does not have a turbo jump, so that's good. That's actually. Okay, that might work, right? Come on, 70, please. Oh, this can, you can win here. I think you can win. Oh, we have to counterattack to waste. We have to counterattack to waste if it goes wrong. And there we go, that's the miss. Yum. That's what I like to see. Okay, so we can win the game right here, guys. We can win the game right here. He has to defend his goal. And we have the chance to win. Grasnov will knock me out. So let's hope he hits the 70. He doesn't. That's unfortunate. But this guy will never get weight now. Unless Lively Dance goes on. Oh, his Steinkel got knocked out. That's crazy, dude. That's crazy, though. He has purple. I'm actually gonna let him stay here. Let's see if we can win the game. Okay, if we get the knockout here, that's not gonna be very nice, because we get to move back, and that will allow him to move up his cycle. So I'll just try to get this knockout here. And we do, so that's great. We need to remove that marker. We can still get the W. That will be a surround kill then. Dang it. Come on, we should make this happen. And I have to waste the counterattack. Oh, I cannot use it. That's a weight loss, damn it. Well, that was game there. GG to Tarble. We'll play another match, okay? We'll play a third match. So definitely a good game to Tarble. I'll say to GG win, and we'll see you in the next match. Peace. Okay, so we found our last opponent of the day. Let's see what it is going to be. It's going to be an Ultra Beast deck. Interesting to play against Ultra Beast decks. Because we do have the Nebi that can call, that can actually just net, how is it called? Nebi's power to get something back. That will only work once. So I don't have a second Cosmo, so that will not work. So we need to be careful. It's gonna go out right away with Celesteela. Okay. He's gonna set it up, okay. He's going to set it up. Interesting. He's going to do it, right? We'll see how this plays out though, because I'm really interested to see if we can actually do something here. I think we could. I think we could. So let's use Excadrill. No, not worth. We're first gonna go for a long throw here. Just get everything sorted out here. Does he have Cold Block? No. He has Mighty Sphere, so we need to be careful. That can actually screw us over. Is he gonna attack my Cosmo? There we go. Hopefully not. But he probably will. He might as well. He's gonna attack me. Teleport might be bad. Oh boy, he does not have Gold Block. So what I'm actually going to do is I'm gonna go right here and I'm gonna use the counter attack plate, okay? I'm gonna set him right here. Two spaces away from the goal. Right there. We'll see if we can take this victory. We could be able to do that, right? We could be able to do that. And good news is he cannot call signal my goalie. If it's Cosmog. So let's see what happens. And that's it. With this deck, they're gonna take your entry points very, very quickly. So counter attack will be a very, very good play to use with this deck. And call signal will not work because I can still move on the goal. So he's looking for a stun, poison, or a gold attack. If I get the dodge, that's game. That is game. It's gonna be game, guys. Very, very nice. So that's gonna be 2-1 with this deck so far. I'll try this out in like streams or so. You'll definitely see more of this. Yeah. Yeah. So thank you guys so much for watching this video. And let me see if I have something to open right now. No, I don't. So thank you so much for watching this video. Let me know in your comments how do you like this deck and make sure to like, subscribe, and tap the bell so you get notified when I go live tomorrow morning to stream all my booster openings on the next pair. So be hyped for that and peace out, guys.